Describe Young's double slit experiment. That is section A. Section B is obtain an expression for bandwidth of interference bands. The Young's double slit experiment, it should contain two minute slits. There should be screen. The distance between the plane of the slits and the screen is capital letter D. The distance between the slits is a small letter D. Anyway, you have to draw all these, and you have to draw a point source, which is considered as S. Afterwards, you have to explain each steps happening, and you derive, finally, you will get the equation or the expression for bandwidth as beta is equal to capital D lambda divided by small letter d. That equation, capital D is actually the distance between the plane of the slits and the screen, lambda is the wavelength of the light used, and small letter d is the distance between the slits. You have to explain each and every step, actually 4 marks is for that. The circuit which is used for changing alternating current to direct current, that is AC into DC, is, we know that is a is called the rectifier. With the help of a neat circuit diagram, explain the working of a full wave rectifier. So, for that, first of all, we have to draw the circuit diagram. It should contain two diodes, capital D 1 and capital D 2. We have to draw the section of a transformer. We are using a center tap transformer, and then after drawing the figure, the final DC voltage will be obtained across the load resistance. Generally, we represent load resistance as RL. Afterwards, you have to explain the during the positive half cycle of input AC supply, one of the diodes, say capital D 1, will be forward biased, because the P region of the diode will be at a higher potential and the N region will be at a lower potential. At that time, the second diode D 2 will be reverse biased. So, during the positive half cycle of input AC signal, the diode D 1 will be conducting current. Corresponding to that, we will get a potential drop across the load resistance. At that time, the diode, second diode, is not at all conducting. So, no current will be, or no voltage will be obtained in that case of the diode. During the negative half cycle, exactly reverse thing happen. The second diode will be, the P region of the second diode will be at a higher potential, N region will be lower potential. So, second diode will conduct current. So, correspondingly, we get an output voltage. At that time, diode D 1 will be reverse biased. As we see that during the positive as well as the negative half cycle, that is for the full cycle of AC, one of the diode will be conducting, the other diode will be not conducting. Anyway, the positive half cycle as well as the negative half cycle at two times separately, we are getting rectification, that is AC is converted to DC. And it also write the value of the efficiency of a full wave rectifier. The efficiency of a full wave rectifier is 81.2%, which is twice of the efficiency of a half wave rectifier.